If I asked you to close your eyes and think about a robot, maybe you envision something like this. Maybe we want to think about robotics from a different perspective.
Robotics as a field really started in industrial settings where very precise and fast motion was needed. Those same technologies are not really suitable for interacting with people.
So compared to more traditional robots, the things that are, you know, welding the doors on your car in an assembly line, we're making robots which are inherently safer to interact with. Because they're soft or they're small, and because of their size or because of their compliance and ability to adapt to sort of natural environments, can perform tasks that are difficult or impossible with other classes of robots. Take, for example, the RoboBees project, which is the goal of creating a colony of autonomous robotic insects. There's nothing off the shelf which is going to be used for any of the components, and so we have to reinvent every feature of this robot and along the way have new technologies that are developed as part of that.
It's a project on a laser steering device for robot-assisted surgery.
So we initiated the project looking at ENT as the sort of focus application area for the technology. But the more research we did, particularly with conversations with clinicians and surgeons here in the Boston area, we found that laparoscopy and gastroenterology could be exciting application areas for the technology as well. So this is a really exciting project for us because we're getting to leverage over a decade's worth of engineering experience accrued in microrobotic design and fabrication.
So we're working on soft wearable robots to both enhance and augment the ability of healthy individuals, and then we're trying to apply the same technology to people who have some kind of physical disability.
MyOxel is a project aiming to improve the quality of life for the millions of people suffering with Parkinson's disease worldwide. Utilizing novel strain sensor technology developed here at the Wyss, we aim to develop a whole new generation of wearable devices that will improve the state of diagnosis and treatment for this important patient group.
Historically, when people have designed wearable robotics, they've tried to think about how do we give someone superhuman strength. What we believe is that there's a lot of people with some kind of disability who don't need superhuman strength, but just need a small amount of assistance. But that small amount of assistance can have a pretty big impact in their quality of life. So we're trying to take a new approach and say, how do we design new robotic components that are using soft materials to be able to apply forces to a person and without the mass and the kinematic restrictions associated with rigid devices? It's taking an unconventional approach. You're not saying, okay, how do we improve on the status quo? It's saying, how do we basically take a fundamental leap?
What we're trying to do is make robots smaller, softer, safer. These are ways that will have profound impact on our lives in the future, and robotics will be at the forefront of that.